So this video is going to be split into three sections about my Vienna custom string sound. The first one about the controller that I've created for it, the second about how I've set up the cells within Synchron Player, and third about the solo instruments blended with the ensemble ones. But first, here's a little composition I've done to show you the kind of sound that I can create with it. So I've created a customized controller here because I just basically wanted the maximum flexibility of all of the instrumental techniques available to me at the same time as not really having to think about it. So I've got one central slider here in the middle, which is connected to a variety of CC channels, which end up on Synchron Player. And then I've basically got four switches here, which enable me to whiz around four CC channels. So on the first channel here, I've just got a volume control. If I just get the strings activated here. So that's just connected to the master volume of Synchron Player. And I've actually created a good balance of the entire orchestra already, but this enables me just at the end of a phrase, when the velocity crossfade hasn't completely faded out the string, just to fade it out even more. For those of you wondering why the volume is on CC6 as opposed to CC7, I just have a habit of changing everything, so it's by default number 7. The next channel is actually a blend of staccato and legato. So at the top I've got full legato and staccato at the bottom, which is really nice to have sometimes the ability to create that kind of accent at the beginning of a phrase. Sounds a little bit better to me than sometimes just having it full legato. The next channel along, we've got velocity crossfade. And that's really good expression control. And then the last channel is actually vibrato, which is in the opposite direction, so downwards is more. So what I'll generally do is record a line in using the velocity crossfade. And then I'll record another level of detail in with the vibrato while playing back the old one. I can also access a fifth channel of CC data by holding these two down and then increasing that, and that just basically increases the portamento. So I have all of these playing styles available to me pretty much with just one hand and not having to even think about it. After a while it's just kind of subconscious, and that really helps the whole fluidity of composing with many, many patches. I mean, if I look through here, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 patches available to me, all blending together without me having to really even think about it, which is really, really nice. We're now going to go one step deeper into how I've set up the template for synchronized appassionata strings. And there's actually a lot of different channels of data going in to do lots of different things, but hopefully as a composer you can keep the workflow simple while the software does all of the magic for you. So setting it up in an intelligent way really helps with that. So in the last video I talked about how this magic controller was set up to lots of different levels of expression, and the way that you could basically whiz around all of these CC channels and not have to think about it. I'm now going to show you how those are actually connected up to the template specifically, along with some other details as well. And we're going to talk about it in layers inside of Synchron Player. So if we start just by having a look at the violin's legato patch, in my first kind of level of detail here, after all of our pizzicatos and tremolos and harmonics, this is where it starts to get more dynamic and interesting. I've got dimensioned control A actually set up to velocity. So let's have the violins activated. Let's by default have the velocity crossfade up about halfway. There we go, nice tritone there. And when I'm playing kind of normally, we don't really get any change, but if I hit nice and hard, I get the SFZ activated, which is really nice. Extra level expression right at the top of the velocity range. So it's a really, really nice kind of detail to have that. Now, if we go into the second layer in, we've actually got a crossfade between legato, legato staccato, and just staccato. So on my controller, I have the ability to change right between legato and staccato. So if I want to start being a bit more dynamic and it's really nice to have that on hand. The way I've done that is actually to set up two instances of synchronized appassionata violins and have one of them staccato down at the bottom and one of them is legato at the top, and basically have an inactive cell on each of them on the opposite places. So no staccato, full staccato, and kind of in the middle, both of them at the same time. You can actually set it up so that all of these cells will work in a single Synchron Player by using the parallel mix mode instead of the parallel crossfade mode. However, I've actually chosen two separate instruments here because I use different plugins on each of the staccato and legato instruments to give a slightly different effect for each one. Within staccato, I've just got an additional channel of velocity controlling between staccato and spiccato. So it gives me another kind of level of patches to choose from just by how hard I hit. So really, I'm getting three different patches from how hard I hit. I've got spiccato, staccato, and then the SFZ right at the top of the velocity level. So let's go into legato and let's go one more level in. I've now got a dimension control connected to speed, so you can see the speed is actually changing. When I play slowly, I'll get the normal. When I play fast, I'll get the fast. So those are actually connected to the appassionata's different speed legato cells, which is another level of detail that gets accessed without me even thinking about it. So the next level of detail I've got is actually a variable amount of portamento. So you can crossfade between cells by having the little square activated, and that creates a crossfade as opposed to it being a switch. And then within that I've got different types of legato. So I've got the portamento legatos and I've got the non-portamento legatos. So when I'm going through a piece, I can actually, in this bottom level of information here, activate a little bit or a lot of portamento. We can go right up to the top here and create portamento all the way. But I generally find it's a nice thing to just kind of bring in little bits of, because sometimes I don't really want to have full portamento, but it helps with making certain transitions more realistic. And then in the most deep level of this, we've actually got three different legatos all being accessed through a CC channel. So that's the vibrato with no... That's the legato with no vibrato. And then we've got... essentially different amounts of vibrato accessed by this one channel. And I generally find that that's the kind of thing that helps you create expression in a piece, is having all of these types of details worked out for you in the software before you even think about composing. Because when you compose, you don't want the software to get in the way of you, you want it to basically work with you. And that's exactly the way I've kind of set it up. So put one more level of detail in. I can go and put some vibrato in, which is programmed the opposite way. I might want to decide, okay, I want a little bit of portamento on the end there. Tiny bit more. There we go. The portamento actually, sometimes it kind of creates a bit of delay between the notes. It sounds really nice. Let's try putting a bit in there. So it's all about creating as much realism and detail as possible with the least amount of steps while composing, so you can kind of keep your eye on the performance and the music as opposed to thinking about all of the cells and software. And setting it up intelligently like this really helps with that, and it also enables you to access kind of the full library without having to think about it, which is a great way to make the most of the product. So bringing in soloist players along with your ensemble patches can be a really nice way of bringing some crispness out in your music. So I've actually got quite a few different instruments here, all acting as one. I've got the legato lines on this instrument, I've got the staccato lines on this instrument, and then at the same time I've got a soloist playing on this channel and another soloist playing the staccato here. And that soloist helps to bring out some of the crispness. And because of Synchron Player's flexibility, I can actually map it so that the vibrato channel for the melodic appassionata violins acts also as the volume for the soloist melody. So it means that when I've got a vibrato increase, I actually increase the soloist too, so it brings the crispness out. So you've got an incredible amount of detail going on there with kind of just one control. If we go into the staccato patch, let's just turn this staccato down a bit. I've got a soloist staccatoing too. It helps create the bite at the beginning of the note. So the appassionatas are kind of a more of distant sound, but you have this soloist right up close and it helps to... You know, it really creates that crispness there.